We've talked about doing this before in video number 233, where we took the board from an Audinate Avio adapter and added it to a cat box from Sound Tools. This time it's the ATOMOS Ninja Flame, though, that we compared in video 219 to the newer Ninja 5. One thing we really didn't get into in that video was working with audio on these older Ninja Flames. Stereo isn't so important here when filming, it's mostly filming stuff at a workbench, but capturing a safety track at a lower level than the main track is absolutely critical. Things like setting boxes down or using tools to cut things can often make really sharp percussive noises, and having that safety track 6 or more dB underneath the main track can really help to make sure we don't clip things. Since getting this Flame model with the single 3.5mm audio input, we've simply used an XLR to 3.5mm adapter and fed a mono signal to it from the mixing board across the room. That mixing board picks up microphones from all over the space, but specifically from a microphone at the workbench most of the time in this example. And that mixer also has a Dante card in it. And if this recorder had a Dante input, it would be a good bit easier to swap back and forth between dual mono and stereo without having to dig for adapters and add another cable. And it would eliminate the heavy XLR cables and the adapter hanging from the monitor in favor of a lighter network cable that could be installed more securely. Now, this attempt here is really just a minimal proof of concept kind of thing, something that will work well enough to live with and use for a while before deciding to more permanently modify any of this gear. What will end up happening to make this more permanent is I will have to physically cut the Avio adapter apart to get the board out to then mount that inside the Ninja. And that's part of what the previous videos were about, specifically video number 233, is the fact that they don't just sell these boards to do things like this. Now, this is not a discussion about selling the raw Dante chips. That's a whole other discussion. These are just boards that have the chips on already, and you just solder XLR connectors. In the case of an Avio, they're just soldered to the XLR connectors that dangle. And all that people doing this are saying is that we don't want the XLRs. We would just like to solder our own connections. And that means that you can put them inside of things and then connect them to existing connectors. It's really not that big of a deal. People talking about developer kits and all this other stuff, it really, you know, starts to make your head want to burst, because all we're talking about is soldering XLR connectors and an RJ45 connector. And it's annoying to have to get a Dremel out and take a whole thing apart just to get the board out of it. So the first step to try this out is to at least take the XLR connectors off of the Avio adapter. And that's done pretty quickly just by desoldering them. And you'll see where the 3.5mm audio input is wired to this little header. And in this case, we're just going to pull the heat shrink back where the header is attached to the 3.5mm jack and solder on to the cups on that jack. So we're just going to solder these additional wires in place so that the 3.5mm still works. And then this is super reversible. If I want to take this out, it's just a matter of unsoldering them again from this jack, and it's all back to normal. Dante. This is the workbench microphone. Hey, hey. So this is working great now, and we can easily reconfigure things using Dante to get the microphones or mixes patched to this recorder instead of needing a bunch of adapters. Like everything, though, it needs to get used for a little while before I decide to make it more permanent, and I might just pull it all back apart and put real Neutrik XLR ends back onto the Avio adapter and go in a total different direction. I did try using the M8RX Dante interface at the workbench because it has mic inputs and a 3.5mm return that could be used to feed the Ninja recorder. Unfortunately, that output is a headphone output though, and it's a little bit noisy for recording. If this was just for a scratch track or for monitoring with headphones on set, it would be totally fine, but it's not really what I'm after here. So this simple project has got me really thinking a lot about workflow and specifically how much gear has crept into the room and into the process of making content here lately. Trying to get to know the gear that's sent in for evaluation before making videos, like with the Behringer Wing or with this here M8RX Dante interface, makes me want to use the stuff as much as possible. There has to be a better balance though between using new gear to learn it and maintaining a workflow that gets the results I'm looking for quickly and consistently. With that in mind, I'm pulling this whole room apart right now, boxing up all the gear that's not absolutely necessary, including the Wing mixer, and starting over from there to figure out what is really needed going forward. It's a constant evolution, creating digital media for different purposes and destinations, and it feels like a good time to address this stuff now so we can be more efficient in the future. It's coming up on a year in this space now, and hundreds of pieces of content have been made or edited here for different things, and we still need to address some things like making acoustic panels for the room. We need to make better use of this space in general for working with audio, and it would be nice to move towards better sound quality with less or smaller physical equipment in the space. The camera as well really needs to be simplified to something more professional and self-contained. It's been a great run with the Sony a6500 and its APS-C sensor, recording externally at 4K 30 frames a second, but that is getting a little bit old now. The room itself could be laid out better, and maybe I'll do an update video when it's all figured out in a few weeks, so leave a comment below if you'd like to see more of this process. If you've got no interest at all in any of this, leave a comment letting me know that, or with any questions you've got about modifying the Ninja recorder with the Dante adapter. That's all for this one. Subscribe if you want, like the video if you did. Thanks for watching.